The plane is divided into four parts with the x minus x, y minus y or y dash into four parts. This first part is called quadrant 1 and the second part is quadrant 2. This third part is quadrant 3 or third quadrant. This fourth part is quadrant 4 or fourth quadrant. Suppose if you take a line, it makes an angle theta with x-axis. By convention, we consider the angle is anti-clockwise angle. If theta is 0, it is along x-axis. If theta is 180, 90 degrees, the line is along y-axis. If it is in between 90 degrees and 0 degrees, then it falls in first quadrant. The same way if theta is this is greater than 9, up to here 90 degrees. It is greater than 90 degrees and less than 180 degrees. So it is in second quadrant, 180 degrees and greater than 90 degrees. The same way, suppose if it lies here, now this angle, this is greater than 180 degrees, up to here it is 270. So theta is less than 270 degrees and greater than 180 degrees. It falls in third quadrant. And in fourth quadrant, it is greater than 270 and less than 360. Greater than 270 degrees and less than 360 degrees. Again 360 plus some theta, some value, again falls in first quadrant only. 360 plus some value, that is less than 90 degrees, again falls in first quadrant. And the sign of this trigonometric ratios, we are having one letter based on this we are going to teach. All silver tea cups. In first quadrant, in second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. In first quadrant, all are positive. In second quadrant, only sine or cosecant, because cosecant is reciprocal of sine. These two are positive. And in third quadrant, T for tan. So tan and cot are positive. In fourth quadrant, C for cos. So cos and secant. Secant is reciprocal of cos again. So these two are positive. That means how we are going to do this type of operations. And before this, one more thing. Suppose if it is 90 plus alpha or 270, 90 plus or minus alpha or 270 plus or minus alpha, sine will become cos and secant will be cosecant and tan will be cot. For 180 plus or minus theta or 360 plus or minus alpha, you'll be having sine as sine only, cos as cos, tan as tan only. Okay, everything remaining same functions you are going to get. For example this is theta. So directly we can write sine theta, cos theta and so on. Suppose if we give this one, this is theta. It is greater than 90 degrees. If it is alpha, we can write it as 90 plus alpha. So sine 90 plus alpha, cos 90 plus alpha, tan 90 plus alpha, cot 90 plus alpha, secant 90 plus alpha. How to calculate those values? Let us see. One table I will draw. From that table, we will see.